I am Andrew Ryan, and I'm here to ask you a question. Is a man not entitled to the sweat of his own brow? No, says the man in Washington. Belongs to the poor. No, says the man in the Vatican. Belongs to God. No, says the man in Moscow. Belongs to everybody. I rejected those answers. I chose the impossible. I chose rapture. City where the artists would not fear the censor, but the scientists would not be bound by petty morality. But the great would not be constrained by the small. And with the sweat of your brow, rapture can become your city as well.
What is the difference
between a man and a parasite?
The man still. How's that now?
Where's my share?
The man intent.
The parasite says, watch out. We might tread on the toes. God.
How we plicked away with our scalpels and toy morality. Yes, we could pop a boil there and shave a beak down there, but could we really change anything? No. But Ryan gives us the means to do it. With Ryan, the flesh becomes clay. Sculpt and sculpt and sculpt until the job is done. Change your look, change your sex, change your race. It's yours to change, nobody else's.
We've all come down here to figure we'd fire Ryan's great chain. Turns out Ryan's chain is made of gold. And ours are the sod with a big ball around your ankle. These sad saps. They've all forgotten that somebody's got to scrub the toilet. Where else would we be free from the clutching hand of the parasite? Where else could we build an economy that they would not try to control? Society they would destroy. It was not impossible to build rapture at the bottom of the ocean. It's impossible to build it anywhere else. I believe in no god, no invisible man in the sky. And there is something more powerful than each of us. A combination of our efforts, a great chain of industry that unites us, binds us.
When Picasso became bored of painting people, he started representing them as cubes. The world called him a genius. I've spent my entire surgical career creating the same tired shapes over and over again. The upturned nose, the cleft chin, the ample bosom. Wouldn't it be wonderful if I could do with a knife what the old Spaniard did with a brush?
The Wild Bunny by Sandra Cohen. I want to take the ears off, but I can't. I hop, and when I hop, I never get off the ground. It's my curse, my eternal curse. I want to take the ears off, but I can't. It's my curse, my fucking curse. I want to take the ears off. Please take them off. So tell me, friend, which one of the bitches sent you? KGB Wolf, the CIA Jack. Even the air you breathe is my account. Well, breathe deep, so you might later remember the taste.
For a silk. You know, looking at her now, I didn't realize how much her face sags. Scalpel.
Doctor, she's not being looked for a facelift.
Let's just come in here and...
Doctor, stop cutting. Doctor, stop cutting.
I know that my beliefs have elevated me, just as I know that the things I have rejected would have destroyed me. Have I become so convinced of my own beliefs that I have stopped seeing the truth? Perhaps. I could have been the host of Broadway.
No, we're not.
But instead, I followed you into this soggy bucket. When you needed my starlight, I illuminated you. But now, I rot, waiting for an audience that doesn't ever come. I'm writing something for you, Andrew Ryan. I believed in this place. I believed in Ryan. But when it got hard, Ryan didn't believe in Rapture. Didn't believe in the Great Chain. He believed in power. Now this place busted. And my girl, gone. Slave obeys.